Neața! Uite, ne aflăm aici on the rooftop, ca să spunem așa, în clădirii în care eu locuiesc pentru ultima parte a experienței mele din Japonia, cu precădere din Tokyo. Mâine plec, revin acasă și am stat aici 12 zile, am practicat regulat aproape fiecare zi, cu mici excepții, că na, sunt în vacanță, n-am fost foarte dedicat, să spunem, ca și acasă. Cu toate acestea, au fost momente de timp în care nici n-am avut condițiile cele mai bune, dar acum, fiind aici pe acest rooftop, mă gândeam că e chiar păcat să nu am parte de o clasă finală de yoga și să și înregistrez, adică să rămână ceva, ceea ce cât am stat pe acasă nu prea am făcut. Deci voi face o secvență cumva în care îmbin elemente care mie mi-au fost dragi, cel puțin în perioada, ultima perioadă, când înainte să închei TTCU și în care am practicat pentru împreună cu restul colegilor pentru a încheia sesiunea. Uitați, ca să mă credeți că sunt aici, vedeți în spate turnul acela mare, se cheamă Sky Tree și nu are decât 640 de metri înălțime, așa. Nu are decât, e al doilea cel mai mare din lume. De fapt, nici nu măcar nu puteți să vedeți tot, pentru că vârful lui este în nori. Da? Uite, acum îl observ și eu mai bine. Trecând de asta, clasa va urma nu are o structură, pot zis, tradițională. Este Vinyasa Flow, într-un ritm mai lent. Și voi executa secvența în funcție de ceea ce inspirația în momentul respectiv. Așa că haide să o facem și tragem concluziile la final. O să pun telefonul în așteptare și vom începe practica. Ceva de genul. Ok. În această practică voi executa mai mult secvența și voi vorbi mai puțin, practic, spre aproape deloc. Practic, focusul să fie adus cu adevărat spre executarea secvenței și mai puțin spre a vorbi. Mațele la piept. Spir vor începe cu Surya Namaskar. Inspire. deja am început secvența de practice după o suită de triple namaskara, am format hata și ashtanga A, ashtanga B, câte două din fiecare. Am început direct cu utkatasana, mergând apoi spre tadasana și vă continua o secvență de posturi în picioare.
This moment I'm doing this practice to open the shoulder, but also to get over a particular contraction that I experience on the back, especially on the right side of my back. So I'm using this opportunity to work both, to open the shoulder and stretch the upper part of my back on the right side. I'm raising the leg up,
the leg.
open the left side, the left part of the shoulder, with its inner circles. And look to front.
Sun has come up. This will change completely the energy of the practice. This moment. You can smile. Share. Come to the front. Open half more. Smile to the sun. Oh, I almost forgot the sun in these days. Now I strongly feel it on my skin. Come back. Go up. Follow. Almost like I miss it. So long. Catch. Go up. What you see here is a combination of routines that I learned from both of my teachers, one in physical, which is Mukesh Kothari, who teach me in the 200th yoga teacher training in Cluj-Napoca, and a second teacher, which sometimes I follow on the internet, his name is Dylan Werner, which I also met in person in Istanbul. So I'm combining postures from what I learned from both of them. Sequence that we learned in the TTC and some other sequences I met from this guy. And they sort of melt together into my practice. And I'm happy that I can share this with you, a combination of the work of both, not just one, but include them. Here I'm retrieving my breath and I'm staying for a single moment before I'm getting ready to go outside. Thank you. more time, repeat the sequence on the right side. Balance. Relaxation for a while before moving to the next verse. Here is just a warm up for the wrists before going to it. Asana.
and coming back to the mat. We're gonna start the sequence for the hip open partial halmanasana.
First, we describe some circles or rectangulars at the level of the arms. We bring it to the chest. We do three times. We place the foot to the side. Stretch the left leg. Opening to runner's lunge, opening the shoulder, moving the knee back, and opening the chest. Here, trying to go as deeply as possible into the posture. Coming again out, we move to pigeon. From here, pigeon with a twist. Back. The rectangles. Second time, push-ups.
leg to the side. Side for the pigeon. Then close your eyes to feel deeper in the posture. Then doing the twist in the pigeon. Here we are actually trying to achieve two purposes. On one side, the twist is making the pigeon stronger because we can push with the elbow in the sole of the feet of the foot, and that will help feel better the stretch on the level of the hip. On the other hand, we want to get the benefits of the twist itself on the spine. So this posture, this combination of posture, are usually meant to achieve more things in the same time while finding an easy breath. Keep it relaxed in the posture. We're coming up. And we get ready for a final arm balance before moving into the sitting sequence, which is like the last part of this class. So here we will try the pincha mayurasana for a few breaths. Here the main challenge that I noticed is actually not to split with the legs. So I have to move forward to find that spot where I can push myself up easy. We say we are moving in
into the sitting sequence. We start with the left leg over the top of the right. And we do the Ardha Matsyendrasana. Just a quick back stretch, back twist. Right leg, top of the left. Left arm, goes up, goes beyond. Twist. Let's stretch forward. This is just preparation for the following posture that we'll follow in a moment, because we want to grab both of the legs to raise them up. Open the legs. Keep balance, one leg, one side, open one leg, knee bended, change, to the side. Follow. Legs together and drive them into Navasana. From Navasana, let the legs go down, move the arms to the back, and slowly, by the time the legs reach down, hips up into Urvottanasana.
up
with a handstand, with a headstand, sorry, to complete. These series before going into Shavasana. Get yourself prepared. A movie to final relaxation. So from here, the duration of the relaxation, it depends on how much you feel and you would like to stay in it. But for the time being, the class is over here. It's almost 50 minutes class, which you can practice whenever you like, meaning you can try it in the morning. This is pretty active practice, which should be, your body should feel good afterwards, or you can do it in the evening, but not too late. Something like, let me say, 4 to 5 o'clock is still fine time. Okay, then with that being said, thank you. I'll prepare for my Shavasana, and you can go and stay on your Shavasana as long as you like. Thank you.